Menus definitely play a big role in our programs because we usually need to ask the user what they want to do. Do you want to exit the program? Do you want to start something? Do you want to do something else? And so on and so forth. The things I'm going to teach you in today's video can be used for menus, but also whenever you want the user to choose an option from a list of options that you've made. First of all, I want to point out that to make the menu, we are going to use a validation method that I've already explained in another video. So go and check that out after this one because that's definitely interesting. Okay. So let's get started. I'm going to import time because we are going to need that. And then we need to have a list of options that the user can enter to do something. So in this example, they're really, really sort of basic, but the main thing is that you understand the way it works and then you can use this lesson to make your own menus. Okay. So menu options H X S. Okay. So we're going to use a while true loop. Print and then print the menu, a fancy menu, then the options, H equal help, then X equal exit, start, S equal start. Okay, so we've got the options, then we're going to print a little space, and we're going to get the user input. Put, enter an option. Okay, perfect. So if the user input is in menu options, I'm going to break out of the loop because we are done. We've got the option and we can do whatever we want with the option. But if the user enters something that is not in this list up here, then I'm gonna print space and then print option not available, stuff like that. Okay, so let's try to run this and see what we've got. Menu, let's try U, option not available, let's try H. That works because as you can see, the script actually stopped. So that means that we went out of the while true loop. Okay, perfect. Then, as I said, we can do something with the option. So if user input is equal to S, then we can do something like print processing, something like that. Then we can do something like time, sleep, 5 seconds, then print line, print maybe the results of the thing we've done, and then results here. Elif user input is equal to H, then we print space as usual and print something like help, print help text here. Then again, if user input is equal to X, print see you soon, something like that. Then we exit. Okay, so let's try that out and see how that works. So let's try U, option not available. Let's try H, help, help text here. Let's try S, processing, 5 seconds, results, and let's try the next, see you soon. So everything works as expected. Let's say that you want to show this menu somewhere else in the program. You would need to copy the whole thing and then again and then again and then again. Now we're going to do something different. So we're going to copy this and comment that out. Copy that. Okay, so we're going to actually make a function, get menu option. Okay,
Let's fix the indentation here. Okay, so here we're doing the same thing. Instead of breaking, we're going to return the user input, because by returning, you actually break out of the loop, out of the function or whatever. So you return, then down here, you can just do something like user input is equal to get menu option. And then automatically you are going to have the same thing. So let's try just one, just to see help text here. You can actually call it whenever you want. You can call it here again, get menu option. So after the results, you can get again the user input, but you would have to have like user input again and then do something else down here. So that would be quite messy. So in this case, you can use again another while true loop for your program. So instead of having this like that, you can do something like while true, this like that. So after the exit, of course, you exit the program and that's it. But after the results here, you will get back to the beginning. Okay. Of course, you need to call this setup here as well. Okay. So it gets back here and shows the menu again. And then after the help text, that's the same. So let's try it out. Menu, help. As you can see, help text here, menu again. Perfect. Start processing. Results here, menu again, exit, of course, see you soon, and the program stops. So that's really, really cool. Okay, so the good thing about using a function is that you can reuse the menu wherever you want, and you can modify it in one place and one place only. So let's say you want to modify something, you can change it here, and this would be modified in whatever place you call the function, of course, because you call this function every time. Okay, this example is sort of a main menu, but to be honest, you can use this every time you need to you need the user to choose among multiple options. Okay, so let's try that out and I'll show you what I mean. Let's comment this out. Okay, so for example, you can have like while true print something like choose sport, then print tennis, print football, something like that, and then user option to input option, something like that. Okay, then of course you need a list of options, so I'm gonna write them here. Port equal, let's say running tennis football. Okay, so if the user option dot lower, which makes everything lowercase, so let's say that the user enters running uppercase, you know, or in uppercase letters, like, or maybe capitalized and stuff like that, you make everything lowercase so that you can actually use the lowercase version in the list, in the tuple. Okay, lowercase in sport, let's say sports, which sounds better. Okay, then you break, else as we did above, really easy, valid option. Okay, so that should work. Choose a sport, baseball, enter valid option, running, option running. You can actually do something like running, as you can see, RU uppercase, and then the rest of the letters are lowercase. That still works. Okay, we didn't print anything down here, so we don't see anything, but that works. Now, as a bonus, I'm going to make a function, but in this case, we are going to make something that could be reused with different options. And pay attention here, because this piece of code is really, really useful, and you can use that whenever you want. Okay, so we're going to comment this out. Actually, yeah, comment this out like that. And down here, we are going to do something like get option, then options, and type option. And you will see why I'm doing that. So while true, then print. Then we print, but in this case, we're going to use an F string. Choose a type option. Okay. Then for option in available options, an option like that. Okay. Then enter space, then user option. Input option, if user option, as we did above, in available options, in this case, return user option, else, print as usual, enter a valid option. Okay, so we've got a function, and then we can use it multiple times. So sports. I've got a list of sports. Running, tennis, football, user sport equal get option, and then available option, I'm gonna use sports, type of option, sport. Then fruits, list of fruit, apple, orange, user fruit, get option, fruit, actually. I'll save that, and now you'll see, choose a sport, enter a valid option, choose a sport, running, and then choose a fruit, blah. Choose a fruit again, enter a valid option, apple. Okay, down here, to make things even better, you could do something like print user sport, print user fruit. Let's try that again. Running apple, running apple. Then you can reuse that function. As you can see, here, type option, that's, you need to enter the right option. Let's give you some space here. So here you enter fruit, here you enter sport, okay? And here you say something like, choose a fruit, choose a sport, okay?